I think a lot of people probably remember watching the news and like these terrible stories of people struggling in the wake of that 2010 earthquake that happened in Haiti.
We had a design course that was focused on disaster relief response. We were reading news articles, we were looking at pictures and video from people that were helping those victims. And one of the things that we kept reading about was how it was so unsafe at night.
Anna, who's my partner in our school class, decided that lighting was actually something that should be addressed and was an unmet need.
It was seen as kind of a luxury item. It wasn't something that was seen as a basic need, and we really thought that it needed to be a basic need.
My name is Andrea Sreshta, and I'm one of the co-founders of LuminAID.
My name is Anna, and I'm the co-founder of LuminAID Lab, and we are located in Chicago, Illinois.
I think a lot of people probably remember watching the news and like these terrible stories of people struggling in the wake of that disaster.
What struck us was just how they had to be concerned with their personal safety when the sun went down.
Most people feel compelled when they see stories like that to be like, well, what could I do to help? In terms of design, was there something that we could design that would improve upon the situation? And that was just an open-ended question. So the original idea is just a solar circuit with LEDs and a rechargeable battery laminated into an inflatable core. And what that core does is it just diffuses the light like a lantern, it makes it waterproof, it floats, and then when it's deflated, you can pack it up, charge it on your bag, charge it on the go, and it packs super flat.
We took that design, we refined it for a while, for maybe like a year or so, just prototyping different iterations of it. And to be honest, like our first prototype to like what we first got manufactured didn't look that different. We looked at it as a project very early on, not necessarily as like growing a huge business or anything like that. We really just wanted to take the next step and look at it very strategically as like, okay, like how do we get to point B, and then how do we get to point C, and then how do we get to point D?
Crowdfunding played a huge role because it enabled us to get funding in a key moment in time when we needed to scale up our manufacturing from a handheld prototype to like, how do we make 1,000 of these?
We went on Shark Tank in 2015, and that was our first fundraise. We practiced our pitch, we knew everything. We were just really excited by the response that they gave us. We got offers from all five sharks, and we picked Mark Cuban as our investor. I think what's most important for LuminAID is to make sure that our customers are happy with the products and that our products are meeting their needs.
And so we switched up our form factor from this bag pillow shape to this sort of like cube shape that twists down when it's deflated, and then it has this adjustable handle.
Based on like getting customer feedback, they wanted like a strap, for example, to be able to attach it to a tent or to be able to attach it to their backpack.
Expanding upon our like core technology to include other features, like for example, phone charging, I think is really important because it addresses what's happening in the world at a big scale anyways.
More and more people are wanting to make their homes more intelligent. You know, there's push for things like Alexa and Google Home. If we don't kind of stay up to date on those things, then like our lights will not be able to really fit people's needs. We're really fortunate to have employees that are so dedicated to LuminAID and to our mission. Everyone has input in terms of product development. Everyone has input in terms of sales channels, in terms of marketing.
Every day is different and never what you expect. And I know that sounds cliche. It's very fast-paced in terms of the changes we accommodate.
We really communicate as much as we can about the different aspects of the business, and we encourage our employees to really contribute their opinions and their feedback. I think that we're very lucky to have people that have been with us for a couple years and are very, very dedicated to it. There are a lot of moments in growing a business where you're kind of re-energized, and as a business owner, you're always looking for when that next moment of kind of energy is going to come in. So for us, and for me personally, whenever I see images or video or get feedback from people in the field,
whether it was in a power outage out of need or just because they were like hanging out in their backyard,
seeing a family like hold one of our lights and hearing testimony of that person and how it added value, that is what gives me the energy and kind of rejuvenates them, my passion to keep going.
But it's gratifying because it means that people find our lights useful in all sorts of surprising ways.
And so that's really, really important for me, is just to get those moments where I'm reminded of why we're doing this.